From Los Angeles, where are you going to go? Who wants to answer that?
We're going to go on the Baja California, go down the Baja California, and then we're going to take the ferry to the main country. And actually, we don't really know what town we will see next, because we will decide by the weather or how we feel. We want to see the Copper Canyon, which is a little bit up north again.
Yes.
So we probably will be zigzagging again.
Okay, so that'll be Mexico, and then you're going to go into Central America?
Actually, we want to see all the countries of Central America, which is Belize, Honduras, Nicaragua, Costa Rica, all those countries. Okay. And we have one fixed day, that's the 24th of October. We've got to be in Panama at the Blass Islands, because we're taking a sailboat over to Colombia.
Okay, and why do you have to take a sailboat? You're not going on the highway?
Yeah, no, well, actually, I always said the roads haven't been built between Panama and Colombia. Actually, somebody told me that's not right. In the meantime, there have been little trails.
Okay.
But still, they're too small to go with such big motorbikes, which are loaded very heavily, because everything we need for 1 year is on those motorbikes. So we actually can't go, you can't take a street or... Well, a path where you can drive a bigger vehicle.
Okay.
So we have to take either the airplane or the sailboat.
Okay. So you're going to have, instead of the highway, you're going to go on the sailboat and then continue your trip on
the sailboat actually goes from Blass Islands, which is on the east coast of Panama, through the Caribbean Sea to Cartagena, Colombia.
Yes.
And then we're going to kind of go back to the Pacific Ocean. So we kind of cut through Colombia, going into Ecuador, and then Chile, then Peru, then Chile, and then Argentina.
Maybe Bolivia.
Because
I want to write Camino de Muerte.
Oh.
It's a very famous road in the hills of Bolivia.
Camino de Muerte, by the way, means the highway of death.
Yes.
Just to let you know. And he wants to go on the highway of death.
Yes, I want to do it. It's the dangerous highway in the world, they told us, but it's amazing because you will do on 60 kilometers, you will do 3,500 meters down hill, and it's all through the Bolivian forests and hills. It's amazing, and I think everybody who knows, who can find this route, will say, yes, we have to drive.
Okay.
But we have little time. Yes.
Okay.
So
Let's see if it works.
Okay, so do you have anything, both of you, to tell the audience? Any last words about your experience?
Well, I would like to maybe say why a policeman has so much time.
Okay.
You know, and not that the audience thinks, well,
okay. Why does a policeman
go
1 year?
1 year on vacation. Actually, that's not the way. I'm on a sabbatical, it's called. And I saved myself over the last 4.5 years, I saved myself 1 free year. I'm very glad and thankful that they let me do it, but actually all the money it takes, all the spare time it takes, I saved myself, so nobody is giving that to me. So
it's all your money, it's all your time.
Right.
Okay. And Hans, how were you able to get some time off?
Yes, I collected holidays and overtime hours, and in Germany I'm police officer too, and I had the holidays last year I missed, and I could put them together, and my boss told me, okay, you can do it for such a trip, for such an experience, to know more about other countries, and so I have 4 months or maybe 5 months free.
Very good. Excellent. Okay, well, that's about the time that we have now. We're going to wrap it up, and I'd like to thank Julia and Hans very much. Wish them a great adventure. And by the way, Julia also speaks Spanish, so that's going to help her a lot when she travels through Mexico and all the way to South America. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you.
Thank you.